Hello, this is Carrie Mubarak at wooingnature.life. This is the full moon view for February 9th, 2020. We are moving right on into the new year, second month, and the second full moon of the new year. So this is a really important moon. As I was studying the astrology and looking at the intuitive implications for this moon, I said to myself, wow, this one is really important because it's an important part of our collective ascension process. And so I just want to share with you what I found. I will be talking about the astrology of the moon, and then I will also be going into a full moon tarot spread read for all of us. So this is for the entire collective. This is for the entire group of people who are either following or connecting to Wooing Nature. If you want to connect with Wooing Nature, you can do so by visiting the website, and that website is at www.wooingnature.life, and you can check out the services, the paths, what's available, things that are coming up. We've got an online class called Tarot for Self-Discovery if you want to check that out. And then there's also links in the description box below of how you can reach me directly for a personal reading, or if you want to connect on the Patreon account, etc., etc., etc. All right, so I'm going to jump right in. I am reading today from the astrology, but I'm also reading from the moon oracle and from the sun and moon tarot, which are the cards that I normally use when it's time to connect to our moon. Okay, so we'll start with the astrology and then we'll go to the cards and then we'll be done. All right, so keynotes, things to know. First of all, the full moon is in 20 degrees of Leo. It sits in opposition to the sun, of course, because we do have a full moon. And when the full moon happens, the moon and the sun are in opposition to each other. The sun is in Aquarius, also 20 degrees. And then there's one other aspect to note, and that is a trine between the moon and Mars, which is in Sagittarius at the 25th degree. So just to sum that up, so for those of you who know about astrology, you can take that and run with it wherever you need to run. But for those of you who just need a little more explanation, I'm going to get into that right now. So keynotes for the moon, that this is about timing and spiritual awakening. And that's why I said to you that this is going to be important for the ascension process that we have been going through for years now. Years. This didn't just start. If you just started learning about ascension, it's not that ascension has not been happening. It's been happening forever. But we are continuing to raise the energy vibration in hopes that we can kind of get ourselves out of the egocentric pattern that we've been in and start to move toward the middle a little bit. So it's not about swinging from one end of the pendulum to the other, you know, like, oh, well, we were completely egocentric and now we're going to go to groupthink. No, we're talking about moving towards center because balance is really what it's all about. So there are two, in the reading that I connect with, it talks about there being two wings that allow us to fly. And for those of you who are familiar with the Kabbalah, the two wings are considered to be Chesed and Gevura. And that's about giving and also restraint. So if you think about it, it's a push-pull that allows us to actually be able to take off, to fly, or to ascend, okay? So the two wings in this case is about spiritual evolution and psychological or mental healing. So on the one hand, we have this idea of spiritual evolution, being very spiritual, connecting to our higher consciousness, thinking about raising energy vibrations, connecting with people who are operating at a higher frequency, doing our meditation and our breath and our breathing and our exercises that allow us to again ascend to a higher level, but without getting clear about your emotional baggage or your triggers, your trauma, things that you're holding on to emotionally, you're still going to be out of balance. So what it says here is that if you don't have the spiritual side, then you're going to be dry. You're going to be without spiritual enthusiasm. You're not going to have the energy. You're not going to be able to tap into your power. But if you are solely focused on the negatives or the emotional trauma that you are hanging on to or the emotional issues that you're hanging on to, then what's going to happen is your spiritual is going to be out of balance. So no matter what you're doing spiritually, if you're still hanging on to emotional baggage, then you're still not in balance. And so this moon is sort of, you know, pushing you toward that end. It asks us to look beneath the surface of what we do to make up for the fact that we are not at peace and not at harmony with ourselves emotionally. Now, what are some of the things that we do when we're not at peace and harmony with ourselves emotionally? The first thing we do is go to the creature comforts. Comfort foods, addiction, drugs, alcohol, whatever it is that when we're not in peace, we want to feed ourselves physically, or we want to give something to our physical body that's supposed to make up for the fact that we're emotionally drained out or that we're emotionally disconnected. And so we want to look beneath that, and it can come in any form, but the form is usually going to be something of a physical nature. Okay, so look at where your addictions are. And look at what you turn to when you're not feeling your best, when you're not feeling like you're on top of your game. Instead of going to that thing, what it asks you to do is to reinterpret it as desire for the peace, desire for harmony, desire for an internal comfort, not an external comfort. So just kind of watch out for those things and pay attention to those things during this time or leading up to, you know, the next new moon or leading up to the new moon. You just want to kind of keep that in mind as you're moving forward. Okay. Let's see what else we have. It says to turn in and employ the mind to reach for the harmony and not for the physical object. So I think I already said that. The opposition to the sun, the indication is that it's time to face your emotional pain. So this is what it's doing. It's saying face your emotional pain. Don't try to shy away from it. Don't ignore it. Okay. Pay attention to your behaviors, your responses, your habits. But instead of going toward the habit, take that time to say, okay, what is it that's really causing this me to, I don't know, reach for the hamburger or, you know, go and, you know, smoke some herb or whatever it is that you're doing. Okay. It's time to pull that back and think about that. And the trine to Mars in Sagittarius in the 26th degree deals with surrendering to that process, but it also talks about it being a vulnerable place. So it's really going to that tender part that's hurting and letting yourself be there and surrendering to that feeling and surrendering to what that comes from, because by surrendering to that moment, you get in touch with it and healing can actually happen. So it does make you feel a little bit vulnerable. You may be feeling that right now, but that's the way to go, because really that's what's going to awaken the other spiritual dimension that you're really looking for. So that's the astrology of the moon. And now we're going to jump right into the cards. So I've pulled the two cards that relate to the moon that we're in right now. Again, the full moon is in Leo, which means that it is in a fire sign. So we're full moon in fire right now. It talks about this being a time to flower, and it also talks about it being a time for recognition. So if you've been doing this work already, if you've already been in this process, then you should be reaping some of the rewards. The house that this moon is in is the 11th house, or the house of Fortuna, which is about fortune. It's about good fortune. So this is, even though, you know, there's some things that we're still working out, this is a fortunate moon. It's a good luck moon. It's a good phase. And it's very, very positive. And you can expect, like I said, that if you have been doing this work, if you've been going toward this effort, then you should probably seek some rewards. And then it also speaks to performance. So if you are a performer of any kind, you can expect recognition for what you've done. That's just kind of a little side note there. All right, I've taken the liberty to pre-shuffle the cards, so my apologies for those of you who like to see the shuffling happen, but for the sake of time, I wanted to go ahead and get that down. I will be doing a full moon view tarot spread reading, and this is, again, for the entire collective. So if you want to get your own full moon view reading for your personal, you can do that by contacting me at Kerri, K-E-R-R-I, at wooingnature.life, and that is also in the description box. So the full moon view spread is a 7-card spread. It looks at how to identify actions moving forward, it's not about setting intentions, but it's like taking what you've already been working toward and working for, and seeing what actions you need to take to further your progress, and it's also a way for you to look at the blockages, things that may be blocking you from reaching your goals. Okay, so I have asked the question to Spirit for all of us. So this is just a general reading. I also do this reading for Earth, Air, Fire, and Water on the Patreon account. So if you want to go a little bit deeper, not quite ready for the personal, you can subscribe to Patreon and get the same reading for your element. So if you're Earth sign, Air sign, Fire sign, or Water sign, you can get that information there. All right, now I'm going to jump in. All right, so the very first card here is, where are we right now in our lives? Collectively, we are in a place of power. We're actually in a good position where we can access the energy of the universe. We can access the resources that are available to us, and we can use that to manifest what it is that we want right down here on planet Earth in our lives. So this is a great time. It's a time to access the strength and the power that comes from on high, that comes from the Spirit, and we can utilize that right now, and that's a good place to be. The second card talks about, how do we project ourselves into the world? So this is where we are. This is our capability. This is our access point right here. But how we're projecting ourselves in the world right now is the Prince of Wands in reverse. Now, the Wands is represents fire, which is associated with Spirit. So, you know, when we were talking about spiritual attainment and then where you are psychologically and whether or not emotionally you're in a good place. So what this tells me is that we are still working toward our spiritual advancement. We are still at a place that we're trying to, you know, figure that out. The Knights, which the Prince in this particular deck corresponds to the Knights in the regular tarot. But the Knights are what we want to call, like, you know, you're still in a learning phase. You're kind of in the in-between phase. If you would like to think of it as being a teenager as opposed to an adult. And in this case, because it is coming in reverse, it just tells me that spiritually we are still working toward the goal of being able to access those places of power within ourselves and amongst ourselves, and then being able to use it. So we're still learning. We're still processing. We're still getting there. And of course, if this is what's happening spiritually, then if we take into consideration the astrology of dealing with the emotional issues, then the idea is that if you want to advance spiritually, if you want to get to a better place, it's time to let go of the emotional wounds. It's time to get rid of the old baggage. It's time to deal with your emotions. If you're high strung on the emotions, or if you're absent in the emotions, either way, you want to bring that back into balance. The third card represents what's blocking our goals and blocking us from, again, being able to be at this place. And that is judgment. For me, judgment is about timing. It's really about you're not blocking it. We're not blocking it. There's a higher force that's really pulling us back and saying, hey, not right now. You're almost there, but there's still some things you need to work out. There's still some things you need to deal with. So if you're feeling like you're blocked, it's not really blocking. You're not blocking. Somebody else isn't blocking. The timing is not right. So we're waiting on timing right now. That's not in your control. All you have to do is continue to do the work. Continue to do the work. And when the timing is right for your ascension, it will just happen. It'll happen like bing, and all of a sudden you're on to the next. The fourth card talks about what we need to do to overcome the obstacles. We've got the Four of Swords in reverse. The Four of Swords upright is about getting rest, taking a break, getting away from the fray and kind of going in. But in this case, it's in reverse. So if we want to get past the obstacles, we have to be with each other. You can't sit on your laurels. You can't say, well, I did this already and I'm done. I don't feel like it no more. No, we still have to continue to push forward. And I think that connecting with other people is going to be an important part of that process and making connections. So if you're feeling tired, lethargic, anything like that, yeah, go get your rest by all means. But the way to kind of get out of that for the sake of ascension is to make connections with other people and also to continue to push forward. It's not a time to rest on this, okay? Fifth card, what you can do within yourself in order to achieve your desires. There's the devil. The devil shows up here. The devil is about sabotaging yourself. It's about hindering yourself in any way. And the hindrance, again, is within in this particular case. So anything that's still dragging you, anything that's considered to be an emotional baggage for you, anywhere where you're seeing that not forgiving or not letting go or not releasing the past is binding you up, you want to deal with that right now. That's what you can do. Now, remember we said that a lot of this is about divine timing. This is true. But while you're waiting for the divine timing, don't forget to do the work. Don't forget to do the work. All right. Sixth card is what you can learn from each other. Remember I said you got to get together. What you can learn from each other is the Prince of Pentacles in reverse. Pentacles represents the physical. Remember when I was saying that you can't turn to the physical things? You can't go and, you know, eat because you feel sad, or drink because you feel sad, or try to self-medicate because you're not feeling your best. This is what we can learn from each other and remind each other about. Hey, don't go to the physical. Get your accountability partners together. Get those people that support you. Those people who are in your corner, truly in your corner with you. And you all work with each other. Connect with each other. Say, hey, you know, Carrie, don't eat that chocolate cake. Just go within and figure out what it is that's separating you from your peace? What's disconnecting you from your personal internal harmony? Okay, so, you know, support each other through that process. And then the last card talks about the projected outcome. The projected outcome here is the change. Wheel of Fortune represents change. It represents turning a corner. It means getting around where you've been right now. So if we're following what the astrology is suggesting, and also if we're following what intuitively has been given to us here and with the cards or what have you, then you can expect change, and the change, a positive change, to happen in your life. Okay, so that is the full moon view for February 9th. I hope you're having a great full moon. Like I said, if you want to know what's going on with you according to your element, or if you need a personal full moon reading, reach out to me. I'll be glad to help you. Don't forget, we've got that class going on, Tarot for Self-Discovery. It is online. It is self-paced. It is in-depth. When you get finished with this class, you'll be able to read yourself and anybody else for that matter. So jump right in. As always, I hope you're having a great full moon, and I hope you have a wonderful life.